that is preached, that is used, that will bring value into your life. I pray in Jesus' name, value shall be added into your life and destiny. I say value shall be added into your life and destiny. Every word that is preached should be used. God said, it's not the hearers of the law that shall be justified, but the doer of the same. When you become a doer of the word, you train. God said, I love people who train you after the word. What they are just waiting for is God. Just say it. Once you say it, no matter how difficult it is, I will do it. I will do it. Those are the people God is looking for. Those are the people God is, those are the people favor will surround like a shield. Bible says in Psalm 5 and 12, say the Lord will bless the righteous with favor. Favor is the first blessing that God blesses the righteous. He will bless the righteous with what? He will just put favor upon you. And you will see things turning up, moving forward. You will just see it in your life. And I decree favor over your life. You will not live here empty this morning. I said you will not live here empty this morning. I said you will not live here empty this morning. Favor is what you need. Some people, if the pastor is not the one preaching, they don't believe that God is speaking. Pride. Tell your neighbor, say pride. They don't believe that God is speaking. They don't believe. It's not a church. Pride. And such people will not. Your head will lack ointment. There is a spiritual ointment. Your head will lack the body of God. Then you will be fruitful spiritually. Nothing will come into your life because you are proud. It is the word of God that is being preached, whoever is preaching it. Because the time may come, you may not see pastor maybe 100% in a year on a Sunday. You may have other calling, other things for the ministry, other things to do. That if you not say, that's right. Are you listening to me? That's right. And when you are like that, God will make sure that your head will lack. We just lack. But do not allow your head to lack what? Point. Because you need it for your progress. You need it for your progress. Pride takes away from all that we never imagined. Pride. Some people want to bless you, but God, it's in wood. It's in wood. We would let you go. Then when can we start for the other? Because you already be who we have to be. Because you already be complete. Because when you behave as if, don't need anybody. No, you need everybody. The fire and the mountain ask for nothing come up. Praise the Lord. You need to understand that favor comes to humble people. Favor comes to humble people. Another thing I would like to say, number two of today, in order to get favor, what am I supposed to do? Pray and ask God for his favor. Pray and ask God for his favor. Favor can be asked for. Demand for it day and night. Listen to me. Demand for it day and night. There was a man in the Bible who lived beyond his age before God favored him. In the book of Luke chapter 2, we read from verse 25. The name by the name is Simeon. The Bible says God appeared to him in his day, you know, in his own generation, you will not die until you see Jesus. The Bible says he was an old man full of age. He kept living, all his mates are dead. Favor kept him alive. Even when he's supposed to die. Because God told him, you will not die until you see Jesus. That was favor. May you see Jesus. May you see him in your family. May you see him in your work. May you see him in your business. When Jesus appeared, it doesn't mean that he will appear physically like he did then. But you will see things happen that will make you to know that this is God. This is God that works in my life. Pray and ask for it. Luke 18:1. Men always ought to pray and not to faint. And not to faint. You need to pray and ask God for it. Grace is available for anyone who demands for it. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. Say, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace. That is the throne of favor. Can you imagine that scripture? A throne full of what? Full of favor. Say, let us come boldly to it. Wherever God is, there is favor here. Wherever God is, there is abundance here. Say, let us come therefore boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Grace has been provided for everyone in the time of what? May you have that grace. I said, may that grace be made available for you. I said, may that grace be made available for you. In your own time of need, God said, I've made grace available. That you will pass through that time of need. People will not see recession in your life. Because grace has lifted you above. The days of Noah, the same water that destroyed the people in that day was the same water that lifted him up. Carried the heart up. And yet people are already down, drawn in that same sea. Grace was made available. If you look at what God said concerning Noah, say, and Noah found grace. He found grace. Genesis chapter 6 verse 8. And Noah finds favor in the sight of who? The Lord. May you find favor during this season. May favor be real to you. You find favor in the time of challenge. People are dying. He kept living. So favor can be demanded for. You can ask for it. Come boldly. God has favor. And that favor is meant for the time of need. This time is a time of need in the world and in our country. God said, approach the throne of grace. Be bold about it. Tell God, you're a favorable God. Favor me this time. Let it be your prayer before you set out in the morning to look for your daily food. Ask God, as I go ahead of me and favor me. Let it be your prayer. Don't live like others are living. Many people live out casually, without element of favor upon them. You just come back the same way. You need to pray. You need to ask God, I need your favor. People I want to go and meet, I need your favor. Let them do beyond what they have thought to do. Let them do beyond what I've asked them. Bible says God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that I have asked or think, according to his power that is at work in me. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 21, or verse 20. That God is able. Say God is able to do. So when you go out in the morning, say, God, I demand for favor. Let it follow me. Let it surround me. Clothe me with favor. That whoever sees me, they will see reasons why they should bless me. They will see reasons why they should help me. And may people see favor in your life. Jesus, the Son of God, lived his life with favor. From the time of his birth, he lived in favor. That's how important favor is. If God's son lived it, that is the way I want to be. When he was born, wise men, how they had, nobody knows, in the east, brought all manner of things. That took care of his childhood. And as he was growing, favor was upon him. The Bible says in Luke 2:52, and Jesus increased in stature, in wisdom, and in favor with God and what? That was how he was living. At the age of 12, he went to Jerusalem in the temple. He was conversing with doctors of laws. They didn't chase him away. They said, you disparate, get away. Now, Pharisees are proud set of people. They don't need, even the people in the church cannot move me out there, not because of a small child. He had favor. Ever say favor? Listen to me. They can invite you to their own company, even though you are not particularly major of them. They can invite you to their own company. They can meet. You can sit with the multimillionaires, conversing with them as if you are made. When favor of God is upon your life, they will not see any reason why they should take you away. Jesus sat with doctors of law. He was favor. He increased in favor. Favor can increase. As a pastor, I've seen him preach in favor. In those days, the only thing people give me was shirts. That was the measure of my favor that time. After a while, it increased. I was coming from church one day as a young minister in the lorry, and somebody met me out of the way. And I didn't tell him anything. He just moved. Favor increase again. People begin to give me dollars. Favor increase. At the time, increase again. 200,000. Increase again. 1,000,000. Waiting for 10 minutes. I want to see somebody who will be envious here. Whatever is happening to your pastor is what is supposed to happen to you. And I told you yesterday, I said, I have not been standing in the world. And I have worked. That's the grandfather of faith. But I'm asking, why did you say you was here? I mean, I've been there, but I've had experience in life. That's why God placed me here. Did he place me as a donor? I've had experience. All manner. God has not allowed me to be stranded. You will not be stranded. When devil orchestrates me to be stranded, I will just see God appearing. God! God will just come out in it. An unusual manner. I see God coming out for you in an unusual manner. I see God working in your life in a special way. I see God promoting and enlarging you. Can I hear a bigger amen? Favor is what you need. Jesus grew in favor. Look at his life. He grew in favor. Jesus said, foxes have holes. The birds of the air have their nest. The Son of Man had no place to lay his head. But there is nothing he needed at a time that was not provided. That is faith. He's not here to be the happy house. But there is nothing at a time. When he needed to pay tax, and there's no money in the account of the ministry, because Judas was the accountant. And you know what Judas can do to when you have Judas as your account. And Jesus said, no, bother himself. He didn't bother himself. He knows Judas, but he didn't bother himself. Because his resources is not packing. He's beyond what is kept in the box. You cannot limit him. So he didn't bother himself to sack him. You know, in this world, we sack him. But Jesus did not bother to do what? Because he said, you can't limit me. I'm too much. So he needed to pay back he and Peter. He said, Peter, go to the sea. The first fish that you are a fisherman, the first one, open the mouth, you will see enough to pay for you and me. Period. He was not stranded. When he needed to eat the last supper, and there was no place, he said, go to a city, so and so place, you will see a house. Tell the owner of the house, the Lord wants to use the house. Period. When he needed to ride the limousine of that time, in form of cart and donkey, he said, go out to the street behind you. You will see a donkey and a cart. Hide. Lose him. Let him go. And if anybody asks you, what you want to do? Let them be Lord David. And that was it. All of them. And they carry their donkey. Listen to me. Favor is what you need. You will not lack favor. Whatever you need at a particular time, you will not lack it. Whatever you need at a particular season of your life, you will not lack it. In the mighty name of Jesus. That's why God said we should not be worried about tomorrow. Many of us have grown here, gray here, because we worry too much about tomorrow. We are not married, we are not focused. It doesn't matter what is up. Stop worrying about tomorrow. Stop worrying. What you need at the time you need it, heaven will open over your life. I say heaven will open over your life. Don't get yourself worked out concerning tomorrow, because tomorrow will take care of itself. God has favor for every day. I must say every day favor. He has favor for every day. Let me move on here. Job chapter 10 verse 12. Job said, thou hast granted me life and favor because he demanded it. Say, you have granted me. I asked for it. You gave it to me. So when you ask for it, God will give it to you. Tell your neighbor, say, you need to ask for favor. In Psalm 119 verse 58, David said, I entreated your favor with my whole heart. I entreated your favor with my whole heart. Be merciful to me according to your word. Psalm 102 verse 13, he said, the time to favor me. Say, yay! The set time has come. Can somebody say that this morning? Say, the time to favor me has come. Say, the set time has come. I have discovered that God favors people in the time of challenge. That's what the Bible told me. He looked for a time when favor will be really recognized. That's the time. That when you see that, you will know God is at work. You will arise and have mercy upon Zion. For the time to favor her. Yes, the set time. Everybody say, this is my set time of favor. God satisfied with favor. Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 23. Said, Naphtali satisfied with favor. And of Naphtali, he said, oh, Naphtali, satisfied with favor, and full of the blessing of the Lord. Beside the west and the south. That was when God was blessing Naphtali. He said, that was, he said, you are going to possess the land. The west. Then you'll be satisfied with favor. Everyone say, I am going to be satisfied with favor. Have more and I will come quickly, we'll run it down. Number seven, or number three, or whatever today. Be good to people. You want favor, you can favor others. Many people want favor and they have never done any good thing to anybody. You know, life is all about seed that you sow. God's word says in Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, he said, God cannot be mocked. God cannot be mocked. He said, do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also. I want favor. Have you given favor? You don't need to have so much to be favored. Even little. What made the woman of Sarepath to be entitled to the running over blessing over his life was the little faith he gave to the man. Just go and give me small. You know you want to die. Out of the small one, give me. Every now registered act as a recipient. Somebody is worthy to receive. Listen to me. God is looking at what you are doing. I want favor. Be faithful. If it's only silver and gold I have no God, as such as I am, everybody will have something. Be faithful. A little help. Pastor, I don't have money, but I don't have money. I don't have money to give you, but I will just volunteer myself. I will come and take care of church. Wherever I see cobwebs, they will not survive in this church. Between you and God. I don't have this, but this is what I have. So many people always say, I don't have. That's why you don't have enough. There's always something in your heart. When God wants to favor a woman, in 1 Kings chapter 4, God said, what do you have in your heart? 2 Kings chapter 4, what do you have in your heart? Because God is a miracle worker. He will take out of what you have and multiply it. Not going to do a magician and bring something out of the gift. No, he's a miracle worker. When you throw a seed, you leave an apple. Are you listening to me this morning? Give favor. Be good to people. Be good to people. Be good. I'm going to say, I will be good to people. Be good to people. Help people. When you show help, you will receive help. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 2. A good man obtaineth favor of the Lord, but a man of wicked devices will live condemned. A good man obtain favor of the Lord. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 27. He that diligently seeketh good procureth favor. To procure means to do what? To pass. He that diligently seeks good, find what? Another version says, procure. I like that word. Procure. You buy favor. By doing good, you are buying favor without you knowing. Do good for people. Do good for people. This is a church where you can do good. Do good to your neighbor. Do good to your family member. Charity begins at home. Do good. Let your wife feel it. Let your parents feel it. Let your brother feel it. Let people around you feel it. Let your church member feel it. If you are given, like my father in law said, if you are giving money to a pastor outside and your pastor is hungry, charities begin where? At home. Whatever you want to do, after eat first in the house. Let us see how good you are in the house. A light that will shine brighter, and Father will shine brighter where? At home. You are not a politician. If you're a politician, little thing like this, they go and broadcast the outside. Do it at home. And yes, people in their house are dying. A little thing like this. People in their house have no water. They will go and dig borehole somewhere. Start it from your house. You don't have water. You are digging. Everybody look at me. Oh, that's politics. And that's what Nigerian politicians do. They want to give you a little, they will go outside. Somebody has given me money before. I won't mention who the person. The person went outside where everybody will see it. I knew that this is a politician. I was waving it before everybody else. Publicly. I'm worthy of whether public or privately. But you see, you may lose your reward. I have office. Even if you have 5 million, they want. Legitimately. Everybody was there. Glory to Jesus. I think I will have to stop here. Because I'm your pastor, I'll continue next time. Or should I stop it? Glory to Jesus. I'm not a guest today. So until I divulge everything God wants me to say to you, I think I have about 5 or 6 points. We'll give you under this condition, under this message. Say, he that diligently seeketh good what? Procureth favor. Let me stop there and next slide. Let's be here. I want you to raise your voice before God. Say, God, help me to be a good person. Help me. I want to be a good person. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. Help me. I want you to pray for yourself. You may think you are very good, but see, it's you could get. The many one. Pray. If there's pride in you, ask your God. Take pride. I know I'm proud. Take it from me. Take it from me. A proud person, they are not afraid to speak against dignity. When God has promoted your mate, just agree with God. Not for long, just agree with God. God has promoted this person. And honor the person. I want you to pray, God, help me not to be proud. Help me not to be cocky. Help me not to be high-minded. Help me not to be high-minded. Help me, oh God. I want you to pray, help me, oh God, not to be high-minded. Help me not to be high-minded. Ask God for favor this morning. Lord, I seek your favor. I seek your favor diligently. I want to procure you this money. I want to procure this. Help me to be good. To be good to my neighbors. Good to my family members. Good to my wife. Good to my children. Good to my church members. Help me to be good. For he that diligently seeketh good, procureth favor. He that diligently seeketh good, procureth favor. He that diligently seeketh good, procureth favor. Procureth favor. Help me not to be cocky. Help me not to be proud. Some people are proud. They don't honor dignity. They don't honor dignity. They don't respect high authority. Pray, God, help me. Help me. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. To honor people that God has placed above me. Help me. God is the one that enthroned. God is the one that lifts up. Even if your son is lifted, honor your son. If your friend is promoted, honor your friend. If your members of your department is lifted by God and promoted, honor that person. Pride can hinder you. Pride can limit you. Pride can make God to resist you. Pray, God, help me. Help me, help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord, to be humble. 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 Help me, Lord, to be good. Help me, Lord, to be good. I demand for favor all through my life, oh God. I demand for favor. I demand for favor all through my life and destiny. I demand for favor all through my life and destiny. I demand for it, oh God. In the morning time of my life, in the noon time of my life, in the night time, evening time, I demand for your favor. I give you all the glory, Father. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Bow your heads. Nobody's looking left or right. Close your eyes. Pastor, I'm here this morning. I am born again and I'm spirit filled. I speak in tongues. Raise your hand if you're in that category. I am born again. I am spirit filled and I speak in tongues. If you cannot speak in tongues, don't raise your hand. You cannot speak in tongues, don't raise your hand. You did not raise your hand the first time. You are the one. I've seen you. God has seen you. I want you to bring your Bible back. And come, let me lay hands on you this morning. God has brought you here to save you this morning. That my brother in suit with red shirt, I want you to come. That sister there, I want you to come. Let me pray for you. Be bold about it. You be bold about it. God brought you here to save you. That brother in a native attire, come. Be bold about it. Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Don't allow pride to keep you down when you are supposed to come up. Don't allow pride. Don't allow pride to keep you down when you are supposed to be in the front here. To give your heart to Christ is the best thing that can ever happen to you. To give your heart to Christ is the best thing that can ever happen to your destiny. Since I've given my heart to Christ, I've never been ashamed. I have never been ashamed. I've been moving forward because I've surrendered my life to Jesus. Allow God to change you. Allow God to change you. Place your right hand on your chest. Thank you, Father. Say after me, dear God in heaven, I come to you. The name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, who died for me on the cross of Calvary and was raised again on the third day for my justification. This morning, Lord, I surrender my life unto Jesus. Jesus, take over my life. Take over my destiny. Forgive me my sins. Let the blood you shed wash my sins away. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Father. I am saved. I am saved. I am saved. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you. Look at this man. I want to follow him. They will say some peace on my behalf to you. Come and put your hands together for Jesus. Everyone.
Praise the Lord. Our God is good. Oh, let's take this announcement. There is an addition to our great church, Give God Praise, this morning. The family of Mr. and Mrs. Peter Amos was blessed with a bouncing baby girl on Friday, the 2nd of September. We thank God for that. We announced the passing to glory of Madam Nwagbo Dorothy, the mother of Brother Stanley Conway of the guitar department. The final arrangement will be on the 8th and the 9th of September at Onisha Uku in Ogoluku, Delta State. Let's support them as they begin to prepare for this funeral. Also, we announce the passing to glory of Chief Eddie Oboho Uno, that is the father of Dickie Uno. The funeral arrangement will be taking place on the 13th and 14th of October at Eyulo Oro in Akwa Ibom State. Let's also support the family in that as we plan for this celebration of life. The Reman Battle Hacks Drama Group, in conjunction with Epsilon choreographers, present another comedy night tagged Reflection. I believe a night of dance and drama. It will be featuring Bombi Hilarious Chinedu, song illustration by Sister Shola Simba and RMC. The date will be the 12th of November from 4 p.m. So let's support them in this wonderful gesture. The Women Fellowship invites you to our home meeting taking place on the 10th of September at number 48 Willoughby Street, off Market Street in Oyinbo, very close to us there, by 12 p.m. So women, please take note. The welfare department has postponed this year back to school fair. The new date will be communicated to us later. Kindly meet the King Jumokela, the Sister Shola, the Omosis, Sister Fwe, Joseph Hassel, or the church office for your donations towards this. The Workers' Congress, like Pastor announced, is starting tomorrow from 11. And the bus leaves the church office for 9 a.m. So in case you have written your name, be here around for 9. And every department must be represented. Praise the Lord. Let's watch the screen. Afterwards, Pastor declare the service.
Just stop it because we have to go into the second service. Thank you. If you want the last one, wait for the second service. Today is the first Sunday of the month. And as a church, we have the poor among us. Ever so the poor. The Bible says the poor shall not cease in the land. We have been taking care of the poor in this church. We have been taking care of the poor in our church. What are you sharing there? Okay. Make sure you use it to invite people. We've been taking care of the poor in this church. We pay school fees. We support people in various forms. People cannot eat. We support them. And so many. So we need money in the purse. Samaritan purse. Put the account on the screen. So in case you are not here with your money, but if you are here, I want you to give bountifully this money. They will not come to you, but they will come to me. And we have here the church to supply the needs of someone who is in need. But some people are in need that you will not know that they are in need. They cannot come to you, but they come to me. I want you to be gracious this morning. Give something that can buy somebody a plate of food. So put your hands into your purse and bring out a good offering. If you don't have your offering here, you can transfer money into that Samaritan account. That's where we take money to feed the poor among us. To feed the poor among us. We buy food, we share food, give them money for people who need money to pay school fees and other things. God will bless you. In Bible days, God said, if you have a farm, don't harvest everything. Keep little on the farm for the poor. For the poor will not cease to grow. So when the poor find and will get to your farm, they will have something to glean and they will be kept alive. That is the way we operate here. So raise your offering up before the Lord. visitor before the Lord. Father, thank you for the offering of your people. We give this so that this church can help the poor among us. Father, bless every giver. Father, bless every giver. Father, bless every giver. They will never be poor. This seed that they are given today is a seed that is speaking on their behalf, that they will never be poor. Everybody say, I will never be poor. When you give to the poor, you are saying, I will never come to this level. I will never come to this level. And may you never come to the level of poverty in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Jesus' mighty name I pray. Give, you can write the account, put it and send money into that account, and God blesses you. When you send it, I will know. Put your name there so that when I see you, I can greet you. Praise the Lord. And I can bless you in the name of the Lord. Let the usher do that quickly, 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 quickly. Shall we all rise? God is faithful. Make sure you come to church during the week. Come to church on Tuesday. Come to church on Thursday. God will be here waiting for you to bless you. God will be here waiting for you to bless you. Let the ushers be fast about that. I'm worshiping in Rema Chapel for the very first time on Sunday morning. You may have come here during the week, but this is your first time on a Sunday. Can you wave your hands to me? This is my first time in Rema Chapel on a Sunday. God bless you. Any other person? This is my first time on a Sunday. I want you to come and shake my hand. Come and shake my hand. I'm here, dear.
You will never be the same.
Same again in Jesus' name. Give her back because they need to take care of her by giving her something to eat and to drink because she's our visitor this morning. I want you to move towards that woman there. God bless you. God bless you. Let's put our hands for her. As a church, we must always remember to invite people to church, minister to them, invite them to church. God bless you. Look around you and say, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you. I want you to come here and shake my hand. Come here and shake my hand. God bless you.
How many of you want to commit yourself to the Lord afresh? How many of you want a fresh fire in your spirit in these days that love of people are waxing cold? Help me lift up your right hand to the Lord and say, let praise Him. Let praise Him rise from the inside, from the inside. From the inside. Come feel my life. A prayer to the Lord this morning. We worship you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Has God been faithful to you? Has God been good to you? If God has been faithful to you, give Him a shout of praise this morning. Hallelujah! My God is the King of kings. My God is the controller of the situation. My God is Jehovah Jireh. Hallelujah. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Our God is worthy of praise. In this trying time, we intend to praise Him. Because we are children of the Most High God. He is worthy. Come on. He is worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. We are going to clap to Him first. One, let's go. One, one, one. Let's clap. He is worthy of our praise. We are clapping a clap of victory. So clap like you mean it. Hey. He is worthy of our praise. Clap a clap of victory. Know what I'm going to do next. We're going to wave a wave of victory. Wave unto the King of Kings. Eh? You're waving all your troubles away. Eh? You're waving all your circumstances away. You're waving into your next level. Eh? You're waving goodness into your life. You're waving victory. Eh? You're waving all what God plans for you. Hallelujah. Why are we weighed down? Because of change. Can we find no solution? Why don't we look up to the God of our salvation? Can't you see that our God is faithful? Yesterday, today, forever. Let every tribe and every tongue come to the Son of God.
Come, let us pray.
Lift up your eyes. 61.
You came.
You came and rescued me.
Come on, lift up your hands to the heaven and sing.
Your love lifted.
Pathfinder, hallelujah. Just worship with His Majesty, the greatest of the greatest, the mightiest of the mighty. Hallelujah. Just worship Him. He alone deserves to be worshipped. There is no God like Him. He is the only God that was not created by any other man. He is the one that can make and amend. Even in recession, He has the capacity to make progression. Just worship. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, the Spirit of the living God fall afresh in this place. Father, saturate this place with your glory and grace in Jesus' name. Saturate it with your anointing in Jesus' name. And your people shall be blessed supernaturally in Jesus' name. Father, activate your word in the minds of the people in Jesus' name. And they shall flourish supernaturally in Jesus' name. We lift up the man of God that we minister this morning unto you. And Father, speak through him in Jesus' name. Explicitly speak to him in Jesus' name. Father, as we have clothed him with your mantle, the people will tie to out of title shall lift it in Jesus' name. Father, we bless you with exaltation. We lift up our great country unto you, Nigeria. Father, the Bible says by the blessing of Adonai, the people is exalted. Father, with the man who asks, Father, the country shall be exalted once again in Jesus' name. Father, we'll move from peace to balance in Jesus' name. From recession, we'll move to progression in Jesus' name. Father, the Bible says in the book of Psalm 40:1-3, Father, He said, He lifted me up from the miry clay, He planted my feet on the king's highway, and He gave me a new song. Father, we command with the man in one accord this morning, you release the spirit of the letters in Psalm 40, 1 to 3 into our lives in Jesus' name. Father, new song give to us in Jesus' name. Father, increase on all sides in Jesus' name. We bless you, exalt you. We honor you because there's no like you. And there can never be anyone like you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah. Just bless him. Celebrate our God. Celebrate it. Hallelujah.
Let's celebrate Jesus once again. Good morning, church. The members of our Rema Mass Choir are familiar to every one of us. For every giving day, they lift up their voices afresh to God in a very different way. When I leave the stage, they are coming up to minister to heaven once again in a new dimension. What I require of us all is to join them with our voice, our heart and spirit, so that as heaven open up to us, we all receive the glory of God this morning. Heaven Mass Choir, it's over to you. The stage is yours.
In church, we are here. We just want to bless you, want to encourage you. We believe that even in times like this, where people are having different issues and circumstances and trials and weigh people down, we just want to encourage you, that because we know we have a God that is living, we know we have a God that is alive, we know we have a God that is active. So for that reason, we know we are in His hands and everything is secured. Hallelujah.
My life is in your hands.
My life is in your hands.
Come on, church, let's do that together. And you don't have to be afraid. Always remember that joy comes in the morning. And that for troubles, it lasts not always. Oh, what a friend we have. Oh, yes. He's gonna wipe our tears away. Oh, if your heart is broken, oh, I need you to lift up your voice and say, oh, I know. I know I can stand. Hallelujah. No matter what may come. Oh yes, Lord. Jesus, my life is in. Oh, with you I know I can make it. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. That's my testimony. No matter what may come my way. Oh, I believe that's my testimony. It seems to weigh you down. All your friends and loved ones. Are nowhere to be found. Oh, remember, there's a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Oh yes. We give you praise, oh God. We want to worship you today. We appreciate you. Oh, lift your voice and say, you are. Oh, I know. Do I have a witness in the house today? I know I can stand because of the grace of the Lord. Oh, no matter what may come, Jesus, my life. Oh, with you I can make it.
appreciate the music department once again. Glory to Jesus. I would like us to rise this morning and let us pray. I want you to first and foremost, I want you to thank God for all He has done in your life in the past 8 months. God has brought you into the ninth month of the year. I want you to appreciate God. Come and open your mouth and just begin to appreciate Him. Appreciate God. Give Him thanks. Look at what God did for you in January, in February, in March, in April, in May, in June, in July, and in August. Give Him all the glory. 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 Appreciate Him. He's faithful. Our God is a faithful God. Come and open your mouth and give Him glory. He's worthy. He's a wonderful Father. He's a marvelous Father. He's the God of the whole universe. Let's appreciate Him this morning. Let's appreciate Him for His mercy. Let's appreciate Him for His kindness. It's by the mercies of the Lord that we have not been consumed. For His compassion pay not. His mercies are new every morning. New every moment. Great is your faithfulness, O God. Come on, open your mouth and
for a taxi. I was waiting for a taxi. I was looking at him like waiting for a taxi. Shortly before I got to him, I was removing everything.
This was a man just left his place, of work.
And that was the end of the matter.
He just turned mad, tied up,
looking
fresh.
So when you are alive and everything seems to be okay,
give God the glory.
Shall we give him the glory this morning? Give Him the glory.
Give Him the glory.
It is the Lord.
It's by His mercy that we have not been consumed.
His compassion fail not.
It is the Lord who has kept us alive.
Who is keeping us alive.
And who will continue to keep us alive.
Don't take it lightly when all is well with you.
Don't take it lightly.
When you can eat three square meals a day.
Don't take it lightly.
Somebody told my wife
this last week
about somebody
who said in Kwara State that
what is using to eat amala.
Now is palm oil to eat amala. Have you ever seen palm oil to eat amala?
You can eat.
God is helping you.
You are still complaining.
I mean, not just last week.
Is palm oil.
You know what palm oil is?
You know amala.
Do you use palm oil to eat amala?
It's against the law of nature.
Where they got to Nigeria.
But that's what somebody is using to eat amala.
Oh, God is faithful.
Stop complaining.
Just give God the glory.
Look at the song they sang.
In whatever the state.
I find myself.
Let God be glorified.
Then my life is in where?
In your hand.
So always appreciate God when you wake up in the morning.
Appreciate God.
We stop your complaining.
Thank God for what your husband is able to provide.
Appreciate God.
The man has not allowed you to suffer.
Appreciate God.
Whichever way you are eating.
Look at you. You don't look like somebody who is suffering.
God is helping you. Is that not so?
Everybody say God is helping me.
Appreciate God. You wake up in the morning.
You're about to sleep.
Thank God for today.
Whatever God has been able to provide for you.
Appreciate God.
There's some people in a very worst case, bad condition.
And yet, God has been faithful to us.
So I'm so happy to see you on this first Sunday in the month of September.
A month of wonderful discoveries.
It shall happen to us in Jesus' name. There shall be wonderful discoveries for us in the name of Jesus.
This month you will not die.
This month you will not die.
You will live to declare the works of God.
Listen to me.
We are approaching the end of the year.
God has plans for the end of the year.
Psalm 65, verse 11.
Thou crownest the year
with what?
Your goodness.
That's what I believe.
And that's what we have.
So God has. So God has wonderful package
for you at the end of
At the end of.
Say, Lord, we crown this year for me.
Say it again. Say, my God, we crown this year for me.
With His goodness.
So expect favor.
God to come into your life.
Things to happen.
Expect it.
Because your expectation is very important.
People live their life without expecting anything.
Expect good things.
That's why the word of God is there.
The word of God is to make us expect what God promises.
Thou crowns the year
with your goodness.
He said your path.
Wherever God passes,
He drops something
along the way.
So that you and I
so
can
upon the hills.
God just drop it.
Psalm 65, verse 11.
I want you to expect God to arise for you this year.
To rise for you this season.
We're not being controlled by the policies of the heart.
We're being controlled by the heavenly storehouse.
That there may be meat in my house.
And prove me if I will not open the windows of heaven.
If there is no scarcity with God.
There is no recession with God.
Prove me if heaven's policy remains shaking together, running over.
Amen.
If they are not in this country, God will bring them somewhere else.
I have faith, and they are sitting down.
Faith is an action word, biblically.
If you say you believe, then move.
Jesus, many times, we go to the temple, he saw a man with a dry hand. He said, stretch forth your hand. If the man refuses to stretch forth his hand, the hand will be withered. A man with a withered hand. And he said, stretch forth your hand. He had to make a move to want to do it, and the hand became whole. God need your faith to work. God need your faith to work. God need your seed to work. That's the way God operates. Isaac sowed in that land, and in the same year, he reaped. So that's the Bible way of linking yourself to the economy of heaven. Don't tie yourself to this heart. Many people, you are abusing Buhari. Since you have been abused, did he hear you? As some people around him that will block his face, his eyes, to whatever you are feeling. So stop abusing him and stop wasting your time. Talk to God and do the will of God. Pray what happened for you in children in the physical before they grow up. To get to the age of that, you have been thinking about it. I know some people that their children are about to enter university, enter secondary school. They have been thinking about it long before the children even get to that point of entering there. Many have been keeping some savings in stores for their children's education, pastoring the Pentecost church. And this woman gave offering on behalf of the children she has never been pregnant for. She named them. She saw me in the revelation giving names to the children. So she started giving on behalf of the children. Wanted to build the church there. Said, James, we give 300 bags of cement. John, we give another 300 bags of cement. And she has never been pregnant of them. She has been sowing for a child she has not been pregnant for. Today she has James and John now as I'm talking. She has James and John now. She brought James to my house Now she's relocated to Canada, and she has John in Canada. Listen to me. If woman being can sow on behalf of children they have not given birth to, how much more is God preparing for your life? I'm preparing for your destiny. God said, in this world, you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. Tribulation is not the end of the matter. He said, but be of good cheer. I have what? Overcome the world. No matter the challenges that you face in life, God had gone ahead of you to prepare for you. Tell your neighbor, say, God had gone ahead of you to prepare for you. Say, be of good cheer. Smile. Laugh. Don't worry yourself. Live your life day in, day out, in trusting God, because he had prepared for you. He said, I have overcome the world. God said in the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 3, verse 1, he says, know this also, that in the latter times, perilous times shall come. The perilous time is not going to be based on who is on the throne. It is a normal season that will come upon the world because God has prophesied it. Whether you walk it or not, you want to change it or not, it will come to pass. Everything Jesus said will come to pass. But the issue is that for that season, he had prepared for his own children. God told Noah, he said, go and build an ark, for I will destroy the world with flood, with water. He said, go and prepare the ark for you and your household, and for anyone who will listen to you, and get all the animals, two by twos, in their species, into the ark. For I will rain upon the ark. God prepared Noah ahead of time of the emergency or of the exigency that will come upon the world. Listen to me, there is nothing happening that is meeting God unprepared for. There is nothing happening in your life that is catching God unaware. God has a future for your life. No matter what is happening for your life, God has a future for you. God has a future for you. If they relieve you of your duty, it's because it's a promotion. A promotion is coming. That is the way a child of God should think. Don't think that, I want to buy me. Your life is not tied to your place of work. Your life is tied to your God. But many of us, we don't know. Once something happens, you don't know. At times, God is doing you a favor so that you can fulfill destiny. Some of us are here. God has endowed us with grace to be a creator of jobs. And yet you are an employee. A creator of jobs, an entrepreneur. Somebody who is gifted and graced. If you know how big God has made you, you will not be thinking the way you are thinking. So many of us, we look at certainty and we don't want to go into uncertainty. So a little problem, you begin to cry. Why should it be me that they lay off? Don't know God is trying to promote you. It's a promotion. I told somebody yesterday, it's a promotion for you. It is a promotion. It depends on what you believe. All things work together for the good of them that love God and of them that are called according to his purpose. I was preaching some times ago, and I was telling some people that whatever is happening to you, God has planned for you. Tell your neighbor, say, God has planned for you. It's a promotion. It's a way of discovering yourself. That's what I said. A way of discovering. In times of challenges, it's a time of discovery. Everybody say discovery. At times, you don't know the kind of input God has placed in you, inside you. To also start. Dangote was not born with sin. He was not born. He was not born with all the paraphernalia. You see. But that thing came out of it. There's something that will come out of you that the world will admire. Oh, somebody, your amen is so small. Something will come out of you. You may look at yourself down now. God told Gideon. Is that Gideon? Go in this might of yours. Gideon was hiding away from the Midianites. He was hiding away, hiding his crop away, hiding whatever away. And the angel of the Lord looked at him and said, "O thou mighty man of valor." He didn't see himself mighty.
There's some great people here. I can see great men and women here. Mighty men of valor here. Great entrepreneur here. People with conglomerate of businesses, company. I can see you here. But something will push you there. That's why we call Abraham the father of faith. He had to leave certainty for the uncertainty. But there's nothing uncertainty when God has spoken. When God has spoken, there's nothing uncertainty. Because the word of God is more certain than what you see today. The Bible said the word created everything. The word is what brought what you see. God will give me favor in the time of challenges. God prepared favor. He made favor available for every child of his going through challenges. If you look at Psalm chapter 91, Psalm 91, look at the scripture there. He said, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide underneath the shadow of the Almighty. Therefore, I will say of the Lord my God, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In him will I trust. He will deliver me from the snare of the fowler. Surely he shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover me with his feathers. And under his wings I will take refuge. His truth shall be my shield and buckler. I shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fly by day. Let me move down to verse 13. Verse 13 and 14. He said, you shall tread upon the lions and the cobra. The young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. Look at your neighbor, say, God said he will deliver you. Yeah, we set him on high because he has known my name. One thing God has planned and prepared for his children in a challenging time is to give you favor. Favor during that season of your life. Everyone in the Bible that have walked with God, they have walked in favor in their own challenging time. Abraham walked with God. He walked in favor in his own challenging time. When challenges came, God said, go down to Egypt. He went down to Egypt. God created circumstances that work for his good. It was circumstance that worked for his good. Somebody said, Abraham lied when he said, Sarah was not my wife. He was not his wife. He didn't lie because there was no sin that time. Sin was not. It was a time of innocence. A time when God does not recall sin. Because any time there is no law, there is no sin. So you can't see that as a lie. Though Sarah was his half sister. The same father, but different mother. Don't do that today. Don't say, I'm looking for a wife and I've not found. And I have a sister, stepsister. That is not acceptable in our days. Go far from the. Look at love of Isaac. Look at love of Jacob. Oganimuda. That's why they don't read the Bible. That's why they don't attend church. Kingdom wash any Tuesday. You are feeling sufficient. Look, so my soul is panting after you. My soul is full of favor before God. And people are humble before she. Because I don't want anybody that wash me down. She wash you down. Very tough. I always pray in my heart, God, you cannot give me this kind of woman. If you talk about this, this one, no way. Because of what? Arrogance. Nobody likes. God is attractive. You see, favor of God is attractive to humble people. Favor goes to where humility is. He traveled there. He sits there. He stays there. May you have this favor. May your life never be difficult. You see, what makes life difficult is lack of favor. When you lack favor, your life will be difficult. I don't have any man. John 5. When every man left the man, said, I have no man. Jesus said, will you be made whole? I have no man. Difficult life. The man suffered for 38 years. With everybody ran away. If he had married to the wife to pick race. Lack of favor makes life difficult. May you never lack favor. The reason why I'm preaching to you is that if there's element in your life that is hindering favor, may the Lord stamp them out. Anything that is making you to struggle, may the Lord strike them out. I said, may the Lord strike them out. I said, may the Lord strike them out. Favor is what you need to make destiny. Life is not as difficult as you think. But it's difficult when there is no favor. Everything will be working against you. When there is no favor. Anytime there is no favor upon your life, life becomes too stiff. You get to a place where other people are making millions. You will not be begging. In this same place. Some people will come there with harrow, with aura of God. And things will begin to work. Is it not the same place? That somebody said they don't wear shoe here. You know, they send some two people to a different place. Depends on what you see. I carry favor. When this man that has a virgin Atlantic. He said, take me to a desert. I will have virgin sand. I will start something based on virgin sand. And people will buy it. He said, anywhere you take me, the land will yield for me. It's not about the land, it's about the person. May you carry something. It depends on what you carry. And you must recognize that favor is the antidote to challenges. God that prepared favor as an antidote to problem. As a mercy for a time, for a life of problem and challenges. And I decree favor of God upon every soul in this church. Every one of you will carry God's favor. Wherever you walk to favor, will follow you there. Wherever you get to favor, will follow you there. Wherever you go to favor, will follow you there. Favor is what God commanded. And it comes through humility. Ever say humility? James 4:6. But he giveth more grace. Wherefore he saith, God resisteth the proud, but giveth what? Grace to the humble. He gives favor to the humble. Listen to me. This is where the rubber meets the rope. Children of God. The reason why many lack favor is a little pride in you. You see it in your actions. You see it in your word. That's why you must watch what you say. Watch what you do. Some actions are product of arrogant hearts. And people will see people in authority, they just disdain them. They see ministers, they just mess them up. They talk against ministers in their meetings. The Bible says there are some people who are not afraid of speaking against dignity. No wonder their head lack ointment. May your head never lack ointment. Listen, you should be greater than where you are now. If all things are in place, there are little things that keep people in the place of God, that makes you to be where God wants you to be. Humility. As a pastor, I've worked with people I'm older than, far older than, in the physical. But they are my boss. I will carry their bag, carry their Bible, carry everything. It's not because they are older. I didn't look at their age in the physical. I will have been arrogant. But no! I go after them as a servant to a master. When they see anything, there's nothing like we are discussing it again. No, it is done. There's nothing like my boss saying something and I'll be disbelieving. No. Pastor has said this must be done and it shall be done. Foul. Period. Carry their Bible, carry their bag. If they have phone, before you know what my bag. I'm not a protocol officer, I'm an understand pastor to some of them. All that in the physical. But I will never look at their face. Humility is a gift. Where I am today. So the glory of God is based on so many things. Because we also have appraiser for. When your boss appraise you and mark you down, it's a sign of who you are at times. If you have favor and you are humble and you walk with them with one heart, even if they want to do you evil, God will change it. Are you getting what I'm saying? Walk with people with humility. Don't get to a point that you become arrogant. As a pastor, I watch. Don't get to a point where you become too much in your eyes. Because of what? I look, I watch, and I take notes. Never. Once God had lifted somebody in your midst as a department, as something, honor that person. Never use it. After I know when he came to this church, I know when she came to you, and you begin. God that lifted. It's God that promotes. It's God that promotes. God lifted some people and made them a deacon. It's God that promotes. God lifted some people from department, faithful people, and made them minister. It's God that promotes. Don't now come and say, I will remove that minister out of you. That's a minister. God has just promoted him. It's not man. If you think it's man, it's not man. It's not man. It's God that promotes. It is God. It is God. Join God. To see to it that the person that is promoted is honored by you. Because if you refuse, openly. Nga to je kawo yan ma penle niyan o wa penle bi egbin o wa pe o kan ni mu forward no aje iyale mi aje iyale e ko iwo lo ti di aje fun ara e a certain thing character can be a grave obstacle. You need to watch yourself. Humility is a virtue to be admired. Be humble in your heart. Be humble in your work. Be humble in your action. And you will see the glory of God. Can I hear a louder amen? Let me move forward here. I just need to emphasize that. Pray and ask God for his favor. Pray and ask God for what? God said we can ask God for it. Let us come. Hebrews 4:16. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace. I like that throne. Throne of favor. Can you imagine? Throne. And what is on that throne is favor. Let us come boldly to it that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help. Anywhere you see grace, is an element of favor. Favor. Grace is an umbrella. Bigger umbrella of what favor is. Let us come boldly. God said, I have a throne. It's called the throne of grace. Come boldly to it. Get grace. That's why you must pray. Anytime you refuse to pray, you are not coming to, you are not getting grace. You need, every day has his own grace. Every position has his own grace. Whenever you are, once you are promoted, say, Lord, give me grace to fill this place. Don't just look at it as some, ask for grace. When you get married, there's a grace a married woman needs. That's why if you are not married, stop talking about marriage. I say you are preaching. What are you saying? You don't have grace. You are not married. Marry first. Live with a woman for 1 year. And then you cannot talk. Live with a woman for 1 year. We now allow, if you are, if you succeed, they will not, okay. You cannot talk about marriage. The Bible says, and here you are, you have not even spoken to a woman to talk, to talk to. Glory to Jesus. I always measure people. You are preaching about marriage. Are you married? Where's your wife? As anybody I see at London, you are married. I saw you. Where's your wife? I always, where is your wife? Of you opening, yes. About this share with Juno. You must always in season and out of season. Hey, my God, you will be following each other. You have to go until you are old and. Until you are very old, you marry her. You oh my God, Lord, you want to drop her? No way. We will not allow you. Praise the Lord. I was at home a few days ago. I see some my father, 83 years old man, and my mother. Until none. Tilo. Oh no, she must tilo. Oh my tilo. You can't drop that woman. You have the other, they will have understood each other. You fight and set you. Fight and set you. Fight and set you. And as you are fighting and set you, age is catching up. Praise the Lord. That is the way to run the race. Want to marry? I want to marry. You get married, but be mature enough. Marriage is for mature people. I think I've moved away from favor. Tell your neighbor, say, ask for it. Ask for favor, need to be asked for. Job 10:12. Thou hast granted me life and favor. And your visitation hath preserved my spirit. Job asked for favor. God granted him. That's why he said, you have granted me life and favor. You granted me. You give it to me. Favor. Favor. What is important in our destiny, you need to ask God for it. Another thing you need to do in order to get favor, to obtain it, be good to people. Look at your neighbor, say, be good to people. Be a helper to people. Listen to me. In life, God had ordained a law in motion. It's a law. He's not just ordaining it. He has ordained that law in the time, from the time immemorial. And it's the law of sowing and reaping. That's why I'm always very careful. Because of that law of sowing and reaping. It's there. God is not just saying, let me go and see. No. He had set it in motion. Say, God cannot be mocked. Galatians 6:7. God cannot be deceived. God is not deceived. Do not be deceived. God is not what? Mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also what? Is a law set in motion. He's there. You are looking at how your child is abusing you. Remember when you abuse your own mother too. The law has a way of catching up. Remember that time When your mother speaks, it's like, what is mommy saying? You are now a new generation there. A new generation ma. The same thing. Look at yourself now. You are not crying because your own child abuse you. If you fail to repair, where's your better? Because whatsoever a man sows, be a helper. Nobody is capable enough to take other people's life. Do as much as you can do within the capacity God has given you. Don't ever say, I don't have anything. Some years back, and I didn't have any money or whatever, but I have muzzle. I use it. Some of my colleagues were getting married. I was not even engaged. I would go to their wedding, pack to their houses. Some of my colleagues, many of them like that, pack to their houses. I said, use me. These 3 days, use me. Just use me. Silver and gold, I may not, but I have this muzzle and my time for you. These 3 days, use me. And they use me. Oh, yes. If I will hire you, the engagement clothes, I will hire you. I will hire you. Shoe, I will polish. These are younger people than myself. Help people. In any way, help. There was a friend I helped last, who was my best man. It was the day of his wedding. My wife did not come for that. I met my wife after the wedding. That same day. When you sow favor, you reap favor. I helped him to a point that was so tired. And our church in London had a program that time, drama night. As you see, my wife, she used to be a dramatist. She used to act. She used to be in drama department. I was waiting as the HOD of counseling. Tired, I'd hurt my friend. Telling me, I had to wait for the, but I don't want to wait. I want to go and rest. I said, okay, let me wait for some of my members. Let them come. I will give them instruction and I will escape. It was while I was waiting, the damn cell came. Hey! And our friend. And they greeted me where I was seated. 4:45 p.m. I checked the time. They shook my hand and God said to me, in my heart, this is your wife. We were not friends. We don't greet. I only know how far off. But God said, this is your wife. He came in on the Oluwa Iwolotunde. And that was it. It took her 3 years because I was not good to behold physically. You are looking at me today. I wish I married Pastor you. A man who grew as a root out of a dry ground. What you see today is a miracle. It took her 3 years to believe that God is speaking. Everybody was coming to marry her, doctor, all manner of people. I put a stamp on her. By faith, she went away, sap. Said, wherever you are coming back to me, you can't escape this thing. It's a destiny. I put a stamp. All the coppers, they want to marry her. By away in Jigawa State. She later told me, said, they will just wake up and run away. I said, you don't know who is chasing them. They will just wake up and run away. Amy, mom, fed you, mama. Glory to Jesus. Listen, you need to listen to me. Sow favor. Sow favor. You may not find it today, but continue to sow it. One day you will find it. One day, what you sow, you will reap. Help people. God, help me! The silent voice of God is, have you helped people before? Have you helped people? You don't need to help people with money. It's not mandatory. But such as you have, if you have money, do. If you don't have money, if you just given a direction, Somebody is lost. He needed somebody to do it. Be willing to, the Bible says, be willing to distribute. Be willing to communicate. Whatever you have in life, help people. Be in the position, I want my life to matter to people I meet along my way up. Help people. You have a place in your place of work for somebody to work. Don't say, I want church in here, I want church in here. I want church in here better, I want to want out. Create a space for us. If you don't know who to work, come and meet me. I will announce. People will come. Employ them. They may not be perfect. Help them. Help them. They may not be perfect, but help them. Don't say, ah, I want to church here. I told somebody, I said, hey, is the sister in church that are better? Is the sister in church? Not all these sisters that all are. The one in the church, they may not be perfect, but they are better. The one that are hearing God's voice, hearing God, coming to talk constantly, they submitted themselves to pastor. Under the apostolic of pastor. Those ones are better than those ones without shepherd. And they want to eat you up. They will not consult anybody. They will eat you up. They want to appear to you in the night. They will not consult anyone. They appear to you. Your life will be miserable. The one in the church, they may not be, but they are the one. I met my own in the church hall. Under the roof of a church, that's where I met her. Better follow me. Where am I? Be good to people. Tell your neighbor, say, be good to people. Proverbs 12:2, a good man obtaineth favor of the Lord. A good man obtaineth favor of the Lord. A good man obtaineth favor of the Lord. Be a good person. Who is a good person? A beneficial person. The word good means beneficial. Wherever you are, benefit people. Benefit humanity. Benefit the church. Benefit your neighbor. Benefit your wife. Benefit your husband. Benefit everyone around you. Be a benefit to people. Be a helper. Don't begin to say, I want mommy. I know some people in generation past, it's only their children. When they pray, even in the place of prayer, they don't pray for other people. They will make other people to say amen. They will say, I want mommy. And the one that are not your children, won't you pray for them? And they will make other people's children to say amen. My eyes have seen. They will carve it out. And woman, all the other people's children, should their life be wasted? That's how terrible woman become. Even in the presence of God, they still carve out their own children. Our own children. I want you to show. Check all of them. Shall we rise and let's bless the name of the Lord? Glory to Jesus. I want you to pray for yourself today. Place your right hand. Just pray in the spirit over yourself. Pray in the spirit. That God will make you a helper. God will make you a helper. A helper of destiny. That favor will come upon your life. That favor will come upon your destiny. Let me hear you pray. And pray loud. Let me hear you pray.
In the name of Jesus.
And make sure you pray loud.
In the name of Jesus.
Favor. Lord, anoint me with the hall of favor. Favor. Let favor keep me. Let favor surround me. Soak me with your favor. Soak me with your favor. Oh, favor, Lord. Soak me with your favor. Soak me with your favor. Soak me. Pray like somebody who needs it. Some of us are so full of it. You don't need more. I need more favor, Lord. More favor, Lord. Pray. More favor, Lord. More favor. More favor. Over my life. Over my destiny. More favor. Over the work of my hand. More favor. Over my church. More favor. Over my wife. More
more favor over my children, more favor over every church member, more favor. Let there be favor of God wherever you will come to. Let favor follow us. This is what we need. Favor is what we need, Lord. As a church, Rema Chapu Yaba, favor is what we need in our environment. Favor is what we need, Lord. Favor, Lord, favor us by your power. Favor us, favor every man, favor every woman, every male, every female. Help us to walk in your favor. 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 We'll give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Bow your heads, everyone. Nobody's looking left or right. Pastor, I'm here this morning. I am born again and I'm spirit-filled. I speak in tongues. Raise your hand above your head. Don't tell lies. If you cannot speak in tongues, don't raise your hand. Don't raise your hand. You cannot speak in tongues. Thank you, brother. Don't raise that hand if you cannot speak in tongues. You are raising your hand, raise it properly. But if you cannot, don't raise your hand. You cannot tell lie and continue to tell lie and expect favor. It won't come. I've seen people raise hand. I've seen people mistakenly raise hand and they brought their hand down. Those one that brought their hand down or those one who did not raise hand, you are the one God said I should pray for this morning. Listen to me. Obedience will bring favor into your life. You did not raise your hand along with these people. I want you to come. I have seen you, but I want a willing heart. God is looking for a heart that is willing. If you are willing and obedient, you will hear the good of the land. That brother in the front with a t-shirt, binder, I want to come. Come behind my protocol. Come, that brother, come. Let me pray for you. Bring your Bible. Come and give your heart to Christ. He's calling you. Your maker is calling you. Something will come into your life that will differentiate you from today. Something will come into your life that will single you out. And that thing is the power of the Most High. The power of the Most High. The power of the Most High. Don't receive the power of God this morning. God is waiting for you. Today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Goodbye, world. I stand no longer with you anymore. My pleasure of sin. I'm led of my mind. Oh, that will be the rest of my life. I'm led of my mind. I want everybody to stretch out their hands and pray. Pray in the spirit for this one. That their salvation will be permanent. That the Lord will reach out to them. That the Lord will reach out to them. That the grace of God will find them this morning. That the beauty of God will find them this morning. Pray for them. 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 Say, Lord, I surrender my life to you. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. Yes. Let the power of the Almighty, the power of the Almighty, walk in your life. Walk in your life. Walk in your life. The power of the Almighty is here. The grace of God is at work. The grace of God is at work. The power of God is at work. He's at work in your life. Working upon you. The power of darkness will be able to stay in your life. Lord, it's Jesus. Say after me, everybody. Dear God in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus, the Son of God, who came to this world, who died for me on the cross of Calvary, who was raised again on the third day for my justification.
Today, I surrender my life into the hand of Jesus. Jesus, take over my life. Forgive my sins. Me with your blood and make me your own forever. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Father, these are yours. Take over their life. And they are going to be prayed for and counseled. I ask for the mighty Holy Ghost to walk upon them and upon their destiny. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Come on, put your hands together for this wonderful people. Look at this man standing. I want to follow him. Follow him. If you have your bag here, take your bag along. Take your Bible. He will come to you on my behalf. God bless you. Put your hands together for them. Put your hands together for them. Two females should follow them.
Hallelujah. Are we blessed this morning? If you are blessed, put those wonderful hands together for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and let us do it properly. It's offering time. Let's give our hand to our purse, our wallet, as we bring out a good offering to God this morning. If you are paying your tithe in the house, we kindly call it the tithe envelope, and you put it together, and let's make our way to the front and we pray this morning. Pastor did mention that when we are self-sufficient, we do not need God that is all-sufficient. So one way we can be not self-sufficient is to learn to trust God with our finances. So I want to encourage you without heart this morning, give generously. Trusting God at this season, that God is able to minister to you and take you to the place you need to be. Because our sufficiency is not of our life in one way or the other. Let's bless him. Let's bless him. Titus, I'm waiting for you. Quickly make your way to the front. Begin to thank God for your job, for your businesses. That in this season, you still have to give to the Lord. You can still pay tithe. It's a privilege. I appreciate God for you. Don't just take it anyhow. Do it conscientiously. Let God see your heart. Connect with God with your gift this morning. And the windows of heaven will be opened unto you. So, Father, we thank you for your word you sent to us today. We thank you because it's the day you have made, and we are rejoicing and glad in it. We thank you for the meat in season you're giving us. We thank you for your favor over our life in this season of challenges. Father, we give you all the glory, for in Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. We bring before you today our offering. We ask, Lord, that this because Jesus, we make fruits return over the giving this money in the name of Jesus. We decree when men says there's a casting down, there shall be a lifting for us in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for your sons and your daughters paying their tithes this morning. We thank you because it is well with them. Because in this season, they will not lose their job in Jesus' name. You cause them to have promotion on all sides in the name of Jesus. They will see your blessing in their finances, in their health, in their businesses, in their family, in all that they do in the name of Jesus. And we decree every devourer is rebuked on their behalf in Jesus' name. Father, we give you glory. We exalt and praise your holy name. For in Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Please drop your tithe and offering. Hallelujah. In case you have not greeted your neighbor this morning, please just give them a high five. Say you are welcome to the Holy Ghost powerhouse. I can't see you do it. Say you are welcome to the Holy Ghost powerhouse. The word Pompey Station, Rema Chapel. Rema Chapel is not a local church and how to center to the world. Hallelujah. Where people of the world changing our world through the power of the spoken word. The word works. Share a brother. Tell your neighbor, say, share a brother. The word works. Because God is ever faithful to his work, to his word. Hallelujah. There is an addition to our great church this morning. Let's celebrate God. The family of Mr. and Mrs. Peter Amos was blessed with a bouncing baby girl on Friday, the 2nd of September. We thank God for safe delivery. Hallelujah. The family of Conway announces the burial arrangement of their mother, Madam Nwagbo Dorothy, coming up on the 8th and 9th of September at Onisaoku in Delta State. She is the mother of Brother Stanley Conway of Greater Department and the mother-in-law of Sister Comfort Conway. So let's support them in every way possible. And also we announce the passing to glory of Chief Eddie Oboho Uno. He is the father of Diki Uno. He passed on to be with the Lord on the 27th of May. He was aged 98 years. The burial arrangement will be on the 13th and 14th of October at in far away Akwa Ibom State at Oyulo Otto. I hope I got that right. So let's support this family at this time and pray along with them. On the 10th of September will be this month's edition of Let's Chat. That's this interdenominational interactive program of Minister Mrs. Robert Kanyela with the Singles Fellowship. So single, take note, on the 10th of September by 5 p.m. we have Let's Chat. The Battle House Drama Group, in conjunction with the choreographer, present a night of dance and drama on the 12th of November by 4 p.m. The theme is reflection. So let's support them and prepare to be there. And also to remind all singles that there will be a united prayer meeting today. I hope your prayer before was united. Hallelujah. So united, I don't know what that means, but united prayer meeting today by 3 p.m. in Teens Church. So singles, take note. The Women Fellowship will be having their home meeting by 10th of September at number 48 Willoughby Street, off Market Street, Oyinbo, by 12 noon. So women, please take note. The welfare department announces the back to school fair will take place now next week Sunday. That's the 11th of September. And we are still expecting your generous donation toward this regard. So after this service, kindly see Sister Dickie Jumokela, Sister Shola Diomosis, or you can come to church office to drop those things that God has put in your heart to you to support this program. Praise the Lord. From tomorrow to the 11th of this month will be the Workers Congress at Ilorin. And like we'll be announcing, every department must have representative. So in case you have put down your name, take off time tomorrow is 9 a.m. prompt, no African time. So let's be in church office or around church for 9 a.m. The bus will leave. And if you don't come on time, you are OYO. Like Pastor announced the first service, it is first come, first serve. So the fact that you have written your name down does not mean that you are going to join the bus if you don't come on time. So let's be around on time and be part of this exercise. And when you come back from Ilorin, you are going to give a feedback to your department. That's why every department must have representative. Praise the Lord. Now we are trying to revamp our follow-up in church, and we are creating, or we've created, a follow-up team. It's not a department, a team to coordinate the follow-up effort of the church. This team will be coordinated by Sister Stella Olaleye, ably assisted by Sister Joan Ajiboye. And the following individual will join them in the meeting with me in church office after now: Sister Abisoye Takuro, Brother Dede Ileleji, Sister Mary Iwere, Brother Francis Nwandu, Brother Michael Babajare, Sister Uzo Akiyemi. So you join them in a meeting with me after now in church office. Let's watch the screen. Then afterwards, Pastor will close the service. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. We're going to round off in the next 1 minute. Today is the first Sunday of the month. And on the first Sunday, we take an offering to bless the less privileged. It's called a Samaritan offering. I want you to know that God has provided for us so that we can provide for them. We don't have money in that account that will be shown to you. And that's the account meant to take care of the less privileged. The Bible says the poor will not cease in the land. It didn't say you are not going to come out of poverty. But from time to time, as a church, we are meant to take care of people. In our own little way that God had brought to us. We pay school fees for people, orphans. They are there. You don't know them. I know them. We give food stuff to people that are in their need. And we do that through that account. I want you to give bountifully this money. And when you give, you are saying to yourself, I will never be a poor man. I will never come to a point of poverty. That is what you are saying. So dip your hands into your purse, pocket, or wherever you have kept your money, and bring out an offering that can give somebody a meal. Raise it up before the Lord. 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 And say, God, I will never be poor. I am given to the poor. I will never be poor. I'm given to take care of the poor. I will never be poor. I will never be poor. I will never be poor. Let the multimedia put the account number on the screen. You can write it down. If you need to send money to that account, probably you didn't come with so much this money, and you really want to bless so that we can help the people who are in need. Rema Chapel Samaritan account. That's the account number. GTB. You can transfer money to that account. I will know. Just put your name down so that when I see you, I can bless you. I can thank you for helping me to take care of the poor in our midst. Father, we thank you for the way your people have made up their mind to give to the poor. And they are saying through their offering that they will never be poor. Their children will never be poor. Father, bless them back. Bless them back. Lift them. Change their story. And for every poor in our midst, change their story. Turn their circumstances around. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let the ushers go around, take the offering, and let me welcome people who are coming
encounter with Rema Chapel for the very first time on a Sunday. This is my first time in Rema Chapel on a Sunday. You may have come during the week, but this is your first time on a Sunday. Can you please wave your hands to me? This is my first time. God bless you. God bless you. We are so glad. I want you to do me a favor. Rise. Bring your Bible. Bring your bag. Come and shake my hand. Come and shake my hand in the front here. God bless you. You will never be the same. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Wait, I have something for you. The power of God will rest on you. The glory of God will shine. God bless you. 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 We're so glad you are here. God has brought you here to lift your life, and your life shall be lifted in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to continue to come. There is a grace in the atmosphere of this church that will move you to the next level. Don't miss it. You get this grace when you keep coming consistently. Consistently, God through His grace will turn your life around. That is what is happening. It's a fact. And your own life will never remain the same. In Jesus' name. Look at this woman standing. She will take you to the ground floor and give you something on our behalf. Something to drink, something to eat, and a little parcel to take home. God bless you. I want you to follow her.